Hosanna, right? Lord, save us. That's what the word means. Let's lift our voices and sing to our God and Savior, Jesus Christ. Lift your praise. Praise is rising.
Amen. Let's continue in our worship now. My brother Ben from Living Waters, he's going to lead us in this next song together.
Let's sing this together, God over all. God over all.
We have 10,000 reasons and more to bless the Lord tonight, don't we? And it's a pleasure to see all these brothers and sisters in Christ singing out. We have the best seat in the house up here, I'm telling you right now. We got all these voices coming at us, but you know what? We have an audience of one tonight, amen? And we're going to lift up the Lord, and let's just let it loose on this song, okay? 10,000 reasons, let's bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. seen like never before. Oh, my soul, I worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes.
Come on, church.
Bless the Lord.
Well, let's do that together, shall we? Our Father, we are so grateful that we can come to you tonight. as a collective group of believers from four separate churches, beginning tonight, Lord, a fourth church, that we are so thankful to you for raising up High Pointe Church in Altoona, Iowa. We are so grateful, and our hearts are thankful for your great power and the way in which you have reached different places within our metro over the past 8 or 9 years. And we are so filled with humility and gratitude tonight to you, our Father, for what you have done. Great things indeed you have done. And so tonight, Lord, may your name be honored as we have sung. May you have received our praises, and may you receive our praises. And we pray tonight, Lord, that your name would go forth from here in all four respective churches: Sailorville Church, Lakeside Fellowship, Living Waters Fellowship, and now High Pointe Church, to do the work that your Son, our Lord Jesus, called us to do. This is a night of celebration, Lord, and so we do so with every fiber of our being. May the song we just sang be a true reflection of our souls. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless your holy name. We will not forget your benefits, O God, and how grateful we are tonight to celebrate your name and your fame. And it's in the name of your Son, the Lord Jesus, we pray. Amen. Be seated for just one moment. And I just want to welcome all of you from those four churches here. My wife, Meryl, and I certainly welcome everyone here as well as we represent Sailorville Church. Dave and Deb Heisterkamp, stand up wherever you're at. Let's give them a round of applause from Lakeside Fellowship. Josh Daggett, where are you at? And your sweetheart, where are you at? Let's give Josh and Danielle Daggett a round of applause. And then our very, very special guests, Greg and Laura Pollock, stand up right here. Let's welcome them from the new High Pointe Church. Now, we do this on Sunday nights, but what a special way to do it. We've got cookies, we've got refreshments, we've got water, we've got coffee, and half of you have already picked it up, but if the other half, go ahead and do that. Now, let's take a few minutes to say hi to somebody you've not met and just enjoy a little fellowship for a few moments before we continue in our worship. The Bible tells us that on a day where Jesus literally worked from sunup to sundown, he got up the next day before the sun came up. And that's exactly what it says in Mark chapter 1. It says, rising very, very early in the morning while still dark, he departed and went out to a desolate place where he prayed. And Simon and those who were with him searched for him. They found him. They said, everyone's looking for you. And he said to them, let us go on to the next towns, that I may preach there also. For that is why I came out. This is the purpose of this night. Taking the gospel to the next towns in our greater metro. That's been the paradigm that we've had in the Engage network. The little logo that you see, Engage, represents all four churches: Sailorville Church, Lakeside Fellowship, Living Waters Fellowship, and tonight, High Pointe Church as well. Tonight, I just want to share with you just for a few moments as we get going, a little bit of the history of our church. The story of Engage really began with the death of a vision about not quite 10 years ago. Some 9 years ago, give or take, we had just remodeled this room we're in right now, and I thought a church like this ought to have a basketball court. Amen? There's a lot more amens now than before. I still want that basketball court. Anyway, well, apparently no one else thought the same thing because the offerings just weren't coming in for that. And so one day, sitting around in a group of guys, one of the guys, and it wasn't even me, one of our guys said, well, maybe it's time to plant a church. We had talked about it for about 3 years as our church was growing and coming to that 400 or 500 threshold. And we thought, it just had that ring of truth. And so by then, Dave Heisterkamp, who had been my assistant a few years earlier, had gone up to Algona, was pastoring and having a successful work going up there. And we knew that he always wanted to be involved in church planning, so we contacted him. It was just the right time. And the two of us actually sat down one day, and we actually met privately, the two of us, without telling anybody. We met in Webster City, Iowa, at a little coffee shop. And oh, how we wish we had a picture of that, huh, Dave? And we literally had our yellow pads out, and we didn't know anything about church planning. We didn't have a clue as to what we were doing. But we literally sat down in the space of an entire half a day together. We hammered out what we still maintain today, basically a template for church planning. And with that template, we implemented it. Dave Heisterkamp came on as our very first church planner, and it would be our very first church to be planted would be Lakeside Fellowship. And you guys, Lakeside, remember the very first picture. We actually have a picture of the very first soul that was ever saved at Lakeside Fellowship. I think it was the very first service, wasn't it, Dave? The very first official service. And then after they assembled their core group and they all came together, we had a service like this right here, this incorporation service, where I gave a personal charge to Dave Heisterkamp. And with that, the group came together in a very solemn ceremony. They began to sign this charter membership, which High Point Church will do tonight. And then we began to see this church grow and for the next few years, and we began to think, God, if you just let us do this every 3 or 4 years, that would be a wonderful thing. Well, Josh Daggett came along, and I introduced Josh and Dave. They'd never met before, and then they were just literally joined at the hip for the next 3 years as Dave Heisterkamp mentored Josh. And then, just a couple of years later, our next church plant, Living Waters, down in the south side. You guys, if you're from Living Waters, you ought to clap or something at this point, but at any rate... And I don't know, is this a picture of the first soul that was saved as well, Josh? So, wow, we got a cameraman on every situation. No pressure. Greg couldn't pull it off. Anyway, so here's the first individual trusting Christ as Savior. And once again, we had an incorporation service where Dave Heisterkamp gave Josh a charge, and then the group as a whole, one by one, came up and signed that charter membership. And then we took a picture of this group afterwards, that being, you know, Living Waters. And tonight we celebrate High Point Church. We have a philosophy, just to let you know, the Engage Network. We start out with three simple P's, you know, the person, the place, and then we people it. The most important thing in a church plant is the church planner. That's our philosophy. If you don't have a church planner that can deliver the goods with the Word of God and has a thirst for souls, you're dead in the water. And they are not a dime a dozen. That's what we've learned. But God has raised up tremendous church planners. Amen? All of these guys. And the proof is in the pudding. And so the person is first, and then not pudding. That's not another P. The next P is the place. And we really put that into the hands of the church planner. We give the church planner a ton of autonomy to get this figured out with our counsel as well. And in each case, the church planner senses the Lord's leading as to where God would plop them down, and they would begin to develop a core group. And I have to tell you, as the lead guy, sometimes called the Pope of this thing, I am not the Pope of this thing, okay? In every case, it's not where I thought we would go. In every case, it's not where I thought. It wasn't that way with Dave. It wasn't that way with Josh. And it certainly wasn't that way with Greg either. But it was God's way. The most important thing was we knew we had his leading. So person, place, and then we people it. That's the painful but joyous process of collecting a core group of individuals who give themselves to a year commitment in that core group. And if in that year they determine this is where we belong, then we come to this moment where they sign the dotted line and say, we are charter members, in this case, of High Point Church. So we, as a collective group of churches, we support these churches 100% in the first year, the second year 50%, the third year 25%, and then after that, they're pretty much on their own. And God has blessed us immensely in this regard. So Tonight, we are grateful for what he is doing. This is, as we said, a great, great celebration. And we'll take it from here. Let's just thank the Lord for the opportunity to be able to have this moment again. Just a short prayer with me, and then we'll go to the next moment, okay? Pray with me, will you? Father, we thank you so much for this opportunity, and I just review what you have done in our churches. As you've raised up churches, out of Sailorville Church, coming Lakeside, and out of Sailorville and Lakeside, coming Living Waters, and out of Sailorville, Lakeside, and Living Waters, coming High Pointe Church. And we, Lord, it just thrills our heart to see what you have done. And we're just so grateful again. We pray, Lord, as we celebrate now this moment, this High Pointe moment, Lord, where we celebrate the beginning of this new church, we pray your presence would be very powerful. In Christ's name, amen.
Almost here, Hallelujah, my joy. Wow. Not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to your name give glory. For the sake of your steadfast love, Lord, for your faithfulness. It's not about us. It's about what God is doing. We're celebrating, yes, God's work at High Point Church and God's work in the Engage Network, but mostly just God's work, is it not? It's God's work. And what a privilege it is to be a part of God's work. Sailorville, Lakeside, Living Waters, you need to meet some new best friends. You're going to see these guys in heaven. And it's a joy to serve with you guys. It's a joy to serve in this network of churches. But most importantly, it's a joy to serve our Savior. For it's in His name we praise for His glory. Amen. Now Josh is going to come up and rip on us.
All right, let the rip session begin, I guess. Thankful for every single person that's here. High Point, I'll be directing most of my thoughts right in here, okay? So everybody else, I don't hate you, or I'm not trying to, you know, act like you're not here, okay? But this is a very specific charge to this church, to this new church, and to their pastor and their leader. And it's a privilege for me to be here. I thought about what I'm going to say tonight, and I had this thought today, throughout the day. I continue to have it right now. We have four lead pastors of four different churches that haven't preached their sermons this morning. I'm like, how are we going to get this done in an hour, honestly? And I'll try to keep it brief. Living Waters people want me to bring the thunder. I'm going to try to do that in a brief 8 minutes with you guys here. November 8th, 2009 was a significant night. Remember where you were November 8th, 2009? You should not remember that. Living Waters Fellowship was signing their charter membership in this very building. We all sat in these very seats. We came up and signed the very documents that you guys are going to sign. And I have those right here. And I got them out. Oh, it's not working. Okay, it's not working. But I got those out. I got those documents out the last couple weeks. And I've just looked through them. 52 individuals signed their name on the line saying, I'm not only willing to be a part of Jesus' church, I'm willing to be a part of Living Waters Fellowship and the local assembly of believers. And in that group of 52 people was a younger who would become an associate pastor at Living Waters Fellowship, Greg and Laura Pollock. And also in there was a couple that had just gotten saved and was walking in the Word for the first time. In High Point, it was a couple you might know, Jay and Casey Simon. And I remember that night, a lot has changed in 3 years. A lot has changed for me in 3 years. A lot will change for you in 3 years. But we're not here to focus on that. Tonight, I want you to enjoy and drink up every moment of this moment here, of you guys saying, I'm here, and I'm ready to be counted, and I'm ready to reach Altoona with the gospel of Jesus Christ. In Paul's letter to the Ephesians, he wrote these words. He said, therefore I, the prisoner of the Lord, I urge you, or I plead with you, to walk worthy of the calling you have received. With all humility and gentleness, with patience, accepting one another in love, diligently keeping the unity of the Spirit in the peace that binds us. And Living Waters. I'm sorry, I get so used to challenging Living Waters. High Point Church, I urge you tonight to walk worthy of the gospel. Walk worthy of it. You have been saved by Jesus Christ. His blood has covered all of your sins. You have publicly declared that. Some of you have been baptized in recent days. And you are saved by the blood of Jesus Christ. Walk worthy of your Savior at High Point Church. Let it get deep within your bones, this love for your Savior, and live it out. Paul, when he said walk worthy, that word literally carries the connotation that you walk in step with. So may your lives, High Point Church, walk in step with the gospel that saved you. May there not be a day or a week that goes by in your service at High Point Church where you do not reflect on the blood of the Son of God for you. Walk worthy. You have a pastor who needs you to walk worthy. You have each other who need each other to walk worthy. Sin and Satan and your flesh will seek to tempt you to fall into all kinds of sins and trouble spots. And I'm begging you now, walk worthy of the gospel. And also, when Paul says walk worthy, he's not only talking about how we should walk, but he's also giving us a pace, okay? High Point Church, notice he doesn't say, sprint worthy of the gospel of Christ, okay? He says, walk worthy. And listen, I know a church plant. I know what you guys have been through over the last year. Some of you core group people, I understand what you're going through. All right, you have said, this has been the hardest, most difficult, trying year of my life. And you're telling me I'm just getting started? Yes and amen. You are just getting started. I understand that a church plant can be crazy. Setting up those stages every week, setting up all those chairs every week, pushing yourself outside your bubble to talk to someone new, to welcome a visitor, to get out on the streets and go calling. That's a hard thing. Those are difficult things. Understand this. As you guys continue to enter into this incorporation, you will slow down a bit, okay? You will slow down. But you need to understand in your own personal lives and in the church as a whole, you need to develop a pace that does not burn you out. You need to understand that you need to be serving in your giftedness. You need to be there for one another in such a way that you're walking and growing, not burning out. So Living Water, or High Point Church, my goodness, that's twice. I urge you to walk worthy of the gospel of Christ. And Paul said, with all humility and with all gentleness, with patience, accepting one another in love, diligently keeping the unity of the Spirit with the peace that binds us. Not only do you need to walk worthy of the gospel, but you need to also work hard for unity in the gospel. Paul said to diligently keep the unity of the Spirit, and that word diligent means to make haste, to exert yourself. All right? When we talk about unity, we're not talking about a passive thing. We're not talking about something that we just lay back and we come to church on Sundays, and unity just kind of just happens. Unity does not happen that way. You must, High Point Church, work hard, eagerly pursue hard after unity in the body of Christ. And that means working hard in your relationships with one another around the gospel of Christ. High Point Church, walk worthy and work hard at walking in unity. Because as a church, as you walk in unity, your testimony begins to speak powerfully to your community. Altoona will continually feel the force and the weight of the gospel as you get with each other and you fight to keep that unity. And Altoona won't know what hit them. High Point Church, I love you. I don't pastor you, but I love you. I love your pastor. I love his wife. I love their family. High Point, treasure the gospel above all things. Treasure it with all of your hearts. Never get over the fact that Jesus Christ has forgiven a sinner like you. Never get over it. Always have a childlike awe for what Jesus has done, the miracle of regeneration in your hearts, and walk in that spirit. And then fight to keep that unity. Fight to keep that unity. Follow this man. As he follows Jesus, follow this man for the glory of the gospel. Amen? And Greg, if you could stand up, I just have a personal word for you. Brother, I love you. The times we've had together, the shepherding experiences that we've had to watch you grow in grace has been one of the greatest joys of my pastoral experience. And I just would, my urging to you, all right, is to not talk about the cults during your messages. All God's people said, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We just had to exercise that tonight, didn't we? Bears fans, hallelujah. Amen. Brother, in all honesty, I want you just to turn and look at your incorporating brothers and sisters right here. And glory be to Jesus for what he has done. And brother, I would just say this. With all my heart, lead your flock. Shepherd the flock of God that is among you. Not because you must, but because you are willing. As an example to the flock, pour out your heart for these people. Weep. Weep for them. Preach with everything that you have. We don't know how long we get to pastor. Might be another week. If God graces us with another week. Brother, let loose. Because I know that you've got everything that it takes to be a wonderful, amazing pastor at Altoona. Love them. Be angry at them at times. Preach the word to them. Weep over them. Weep with them. Be their shepherd as you follow Christ. Let's close in prayer. Lord, we love you. We love your word. Lord Jesus, I just pray over Greg. So thankful, God, for your work in his life. Thank you for saving this former drug addict, this individual who was stained with sin. And Lord Jesus, not only did you save him, but he's a pastor tonight. We praise you for that. And Lord Jesus, we thank you for what you have raised up. Lord, truly Matthew 16:18 is truer tonight than it's ever been. That you are building your church, Jesus, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. And Christ, watch over High Point Church. Lord Jesus, protect them. May they walk worthy of the gospel of Christ. May they work hard, diligently, to preserve the unity of the Spirit and the bond of peace. And Jesus, may you bless this church in amazing ways. And Jesus, we pray in your mighty name. Amen.
Come set your rule and reign in our hearts again. Increase in us, we pray. Unveil why we're made. Come set our hearts ablaze with hope, like wildfire in our very souls. Holy Spirit, come invade us now. Church, we need your
your power in us. And we seek your kingdom first, we hunger and we thirst, we refuse to waste our lives, for you're our joy and prize. To see the captive hearts released, the hurt, the sick, the poor at peace, we lay down. Church, we pray, revive this earth. Build your kingdom here, let the darkness fear. Show your mighty hand, heal our streets.
In the moonlit Well, I get the honor of introducing you for the very first time officially to High Point Church. Let's give them a hand. Awesome. Okay, now I'm going to ask you to do your first official act as a church and try to move up forward without knocking over all the guitars. They would like a better picture, so we get everybody to kind of move up in front of the guitars and move in, and even on the steps here if you'd like, and kind of gather just a little bit closer. Paul's feeling a little overwhelmed over there. He's getting trampled on. Wow, when God said he was going to build his church, he wasn't joking around, was he? This is awesome. I get the privilege of asking the Lord to bless you as an official church. I'm very thankful. I'm very thankful for a number of reasons, just knowing Greg and just what God's done in his life, knowing many of you have a son who's now a member of High Point Church. That's one of the greatest joys, to see one of your children walking for the Lord. And so I'm very, very thankful for each and every one of you. Let me ask the Lord to bless. Father, I do with a grateful heart, with 10,000 reasons to sing your praises, I come to you tonight, and I thank you for the great work that you're doing. I thank you for many things. Lord, I thank you, first of all, for your great love for all of us in this room here tonight, that you would send your son, that he would agree to come and die on the cross so that we could have forgiveness of sins. I thank you for calling sinners to salvation, many of whom we see right up here tonight. And Lord, I would ask your blessing. You have made the promise, and we have evidence right here in this room and right here in front of us that you will build your church. And Lord, we know from your word that you have many people in Altoona and the surrounding area that need to be told about the gospel and need to trust in you. And so, Lord, I'd pray your richest blessing. Lord, I pray that you would take this initial group, the ones that signed here tonight, and that you would create in their hearts, even right now, to a greater degree than what they've sensed even before, a spirit of unity and a bond of peace for one another. I thank you for Greg, Lord, and I pray that you would continue to put steel in his spine and that he would unashamedly preach the gospel, that you would see souls saved and they would gather, and Lord, that this would be just another church of many churches to be planted in this area. So we ask, Lord, that you would bless. Lord, I ask particularly, as Paul asked for prayer, that you would open doors for the gospel, that all the members here that just signed would have wisdom toward those who are on the outside, that they would know how to speak gently and yet clearly the gospel. Lord, we thank you for your gospel, how it's marching forward. We thank you for the blessing of being able to participate in it, to see it even from a distance. And again, Lord, we just ask your greatest blessing on this group. We want to thank you for your goodness. In Christ's precious name, amen. Okay, you need to stay there. He's going to take a picture.
Be your hands and feet. I want to live a life that leads. Ready yourself. Let us shine the light of Jesus in the darkest night. Oh, ready yourselves, ready yourselves. May the powers of darkness tremble as our praises rise. Until the whole world hears, Lord, we are calling out. Lifting up your name.
Amen. It's a pleasure to see that. Praise the Lord for what he's doing at Sailorville, at Living Waters, at Lakeside, and also now High Point. We praise the Lord for what he's doing. As we end tonight, we're going to sing about the cornerstone of the church, Jesus Christ. And that's what the song is called. And it's a pleasure to have my brother Matt. He's a worship leader from High Point, and the rest of High Point's worship band. They're going to lead us in this, so let's all stand together as we lift up the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Built on that verse with me again. My hope is built on nothing less.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest rain. Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong, in the Savior's love, through the storm, He is born, Lord of
Thank you for your singing.
Amen. Now unto him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we could ask or think, to him be glory in the church, to the glory of God our Father and his Son. Amen. God bless you. You're dismissed. Have a great week. You're dismissed. Praise the Lord.